it's not only we coaching only for money or we receive money, then we coach better. No, we need to have some gratification. Some gratification is only one word. No, sometimes one word can make you happy more than money. Make them understand that everything is possible is my first focus when I coach one team. In the first meeting, I say to them, I don't want to only win. I want to win and be happy after win.
Hello, captains of Armband. Welcome to yet another episode of Short Corners, where we interview different footballers, managers, coaches, analysts, scouts, directors, owners of various football clubs to bring the various aspects of the game closer to you. So today with us, we have Mr. Vincenzo Alberto Annese, the former head coach of Gokulam Kerala, who have won this and the previous season of I-League. So Mr. Vincenzo Alberto Annese, how have you been?
Thank you so much for inviting me. It's a pleasure. And of course, I'm full of enthusiasm to be host from you and from this telecast. And of course, I'm always ready for explain my view of football for all of us.
So thank you for giving us the chance to take a podcast session with you. It is a very, very good opportunity for all of us to learn something from you. So the first thing, that following your father's footsteps, you decided to become a footballer and played as a midfielder for Venezia's youth team and a few senior teams. But due to injuries, you had to retire at a young age. So how did you deal with this setback, and how did that phase of your career shape you as a person?
Well, for sure, it created me one big impact on my career. I become a senior very soon, because coaching the maybe some people more old than you create me some change in my personality. Be fast coach is not easy for no one coach in the world. Even you have a big name like a football player, it's not my case, because I just was playing youth developing in Serie A in Venezia, but I was not so high coach, so high football player. So I become like a soon coach, and I start to study how you can be coach. And I developed my career in the school. First in the school, coaching the youth level, and then start to my career improve myself with a player in the football. It was very difficult, but also easy, because when I was a football player, especially in the middle, I was very leader. I have a leadership in the group, and I try myself to coach even in the game. And this is helped me in the future also for make some decision. Being midfielder, you see the field at 360 degrees, or you see everybody in each position. So I think who is midfielder, I don't know, is my view. Maybe I'm wrong, but you can see the football at any angle, in attacking phase, in defensive phase. And you have also mentality that can create something positive for the team always. It's not only my case. I can individualize many big coach like Guardiola, like Antonio Conte, that all the time there was midfield and try to see the field in Xavi also now. We have a different vision, and like to come back to your question. Really, I become a soon coach, and I become many injury that I get, I start to be focused on coaching, start to see other view of football, not only see like a player, but see like a coach. Start my career first like physical coach, because you know, with my university, I developing myself like a physical coach, and then like a coach in the future.
So now coming to the coaching career, you then decided to become a football coach after the injury, as you have mentioned. Then you attended the University of Foggia to get a degree on physical education, as you have said, and University of Verona to learn to adaptation of the sports for the disabled people. So what were your key takeaways from these courses and how did those help you to become a better coach later on?
Well, the University of Foggia was the same university of Antonio Conte that became, after this degree, also start the career as a coach. And in Foggia, I learned so much about physically that for me in the modern football is so important, is everything. Because it's true, you need to understand all about tactically, discipline, movement, but without physical, you know, the speed of football is so important, recovery, speed, injury. So this was the first step that make me coach. Then I go to Verona and I focus on disability, and the disabled make me understand that you can win everything because, you know, each disabled have one deficit. And this deficit, if you can win with the deficit, you can win in each stuff in the life. So make me different person after this course and make me believe in what is inarchivable. I believe a lot in hard work. I believe a lot that each person that can go out of limit all the time. I believe that they can create something special in each performance that you can create. I never believe that we done everything in each game. I think all the time we can improve in each game. And this, my power start from really from this habit that I was in these years of Verona, in these 2 years of Verona, I was coaching also disabled. And they give me really with emotion, I say, they give me a lot of power. They changed my mentality because they make me believe in easy stuff that we feeling easy, but for them maybe it can be a bit complicated. And they fight so much for example, one competition. I was near to the competition of running with disabled, and they have a lot of commitment for reach this. So if you one physical disabled that can reach this point, one normal person they can reach more and more and more. And this is so important to understand and let my player in during my career understand this. Be working on psychology for each person, I think is more important than coaching the physical part or tactical part or technical part. Make them understand that everything is possible is my first focus when I coach one team. I don't coach in, of course, every coach do tactical, spiritually, but make understand that we are different than another person, that because we can create something special is the first step that I do when I coach.
So the one takeaway from the whole of your answer is that the only thing that is holding us back is our mentality. So as you said, if the disabled team can give it their all on the pitch, so each and every team can. And one thing that I like very much about your answer was that the first thing you do is to try to instill that mentality that you can do everything at the coach. Sometimes even a very talented team just gets behind mentally and cannot perform well on the pitch. So it's very important to have a very career focused and a very ambitious team to have on the pitch. So now coming to another interesting question, that since 2010, you have coached in more than 10 countries. Have you noticed any direct correlation between the culture of each country and the mindset of its player?
For sure. Example, when I was in Indonesia, it's very, very similar of India mentality. This created me so much easy the job. Also in Indonesia, when I was in Indonesia, I doing so well with one club, PSIS Semarang, that we come from second division and we was there playing top level. We was so young, so inexperienced, and I make them in the good level. And this why the correlation that you ask, like a question, I really follow the religion. That can be something strange, no? Why religion in the football? But I believe so much that in each training, in each performance, in each game, in each starting of our meeting, I put the pray before everything. It's my style, and we pray in different way. I mean, in my team, there was about 4 or 5 religion, and I try to make everybody understand that the religion is so important for each person. They can be Muslim, they can be Hindu, they can be Christian, they can be Orthodox. And I try to make them believe in only one view. And the view is God. The view can be something that is special for us, but this view, they create us like a family. So in each part when I was in Africa, and I learned this from Ghana, that was one of my first experience like a coach. It was almost before to start the training. We make a rondo in the center of the field, and we play like 25, 30 minutes before each training. I follow this view because I believe so much in, like I said before, so much in the spirit of preparation of each training, the spirit of preparation of each meeting or each game. I believe so much that, example, many players, we training, but we don't training for. We train it just because it's a training. No, for me, the training is like competition. It's the same. Many times in my training, we discussion, we fighting, it was like a game. Many times I stopped the training because it was so much competition inside, and maybe we have the game before in one day. I believe that if you create this spiritual mentality before the training and after training, or in the meeting, you can really reach the best for each country you are. I learned from many countries. I learned from Ghana, I learned from Kosovo, I learned from Indonesia, from India. I feel in the person that is in front of me, and I try to have a feedback from them. Try to also adapt on themselves. Be honest, even I'm young, but like many person around, they say that I have a strong personality. Maybe because I like to make decision in each stuff, in each little thing in the team, and this create no separation between coach and player. Many time we see that the player maybe follow the agent, maybe follow the social media, maybe follow some decision, different decision. I try to put focus only in our team, in myself, in religion, and focus on what we really need to do today in the training, what we really need to do today in the game. This is so important for one person that wants to be coach. It's my view like a coach, and I believe in this. Many times I listen some coach that talk in different way for different stuff that is outside the coaching. I never do this. I believe that we are human beings. We can relationship, we can speak about everything in the life. But if we put focus on only train, focus on only win, because we training only 1 hour or 2 hour in the day, we performance in the game like 1 or 2 hours. Other person that going to work, they work for 8 hours, 10 hours, 24 hours. We are so lucky that we enjoy to play football. We are so lucky that we have a good job, good money, because football give also good money, good life, good style life. So we need to do the maximum that we can, And we need to be a sample for other person, especially now that social media, they make photo for everything we done. And I believe that I'm no one coach, not me, but one coach, they cannot change the player only for be player, but they can change the player also in the real life with the wife, with the kids, because they can give a lot of advice for the life. When you win some trophy, you remember this win for all life. You can be a sample for your kids, for your family, for your job, for future job, always. So this can create maybe some similitude in all my team that was in each country.
In India, spirituality plays a very, very important part in everyday life. So to have spirituality mixed up with football, creating such a beautiful amalgamation, I think it's a very beautiful idea to have something of a spiritual bonding before the training session. Because as Bielsa has said, training session is 90% of the match itself, because you do it on the training pitch and you just execute it on the pitch. Because in the pitch, there is very less chances of bringing your own idea. So I think it's a brilliant idea to have something like of a spiritual bonding before the game, especially with so many people from so many religions having on the team. So that's a great thing. So in 2020, you joined Gokulam Kerala as their head coach. And since then, you have won back-to-back I-Leagues, which is a huge achievement, keeping in mind that I-League trophy just moves from one state to one club, one after another. There is very rare the team has won two consecutive leagues. So that's a big achievement. Then you created history in the league with longest unbeaten streak of 21 games. Reached the group stages of 2022 AFC Cup and scored more than 100 goals in all competitions in last 2 years. So how do you reflect on your tenure at Gokulam Kerala?
Well, I be honest with you, it was an amazing time. One step for my career that put me in another level. I can see that what really make me big difference between another team. I can see another team, I talk about India, general India, India, talk about the national team, talk about ISL, I-League, I-League First Division, I-League Second Division, Amateur League, Santo Trophy team. Something different is that we score with 12 different players. That I think in the historical of Indian football, I don't believe there is one team that score more than 12 different players. This year with 12 different players, last year with 10 different players. In general, each coach in one league, they put focus on 6-5 players. We score with a number of the players that for believe in ourselves so much that each person in the team, they can score a goal, and each person they can attack. We can score in the last second. We believe all the time in the scoring. We score in this year's in I-League more than 44-46 goals. We are also are the best defensive line this year's. We are also the defensive line last year's and the best scoring also last year's. And I think this is a fruit of the job doing tactically. We are only one team that play with a number of the attacking phase more than other team. I noted all other team of I-League between last year's and this year's. Last year's was Churchy Brother that was in the second position. And Churchy Brother scored with 2-3 players almost. And this year's was with Momadan. Momadan scored with 1 or 2 players only, with Marcus and somebody like Pfizer. We do different kind of football in India. I hope I make happy, not only supporter of Gokulam, I hope I make happy all Indian football. Honestly, not only data goal, not only structure of receive goal or structure of attacking phase. We do really good football with changing position. Not a lot possession ball, because I don't believe a lot in possession ball at all. Many coach believe in possession. I can be good also if another team have possession ball. We need only score goal. This is important for me. An attack with many person that we can. I think we won the possession ball with in 18 game, that we make a historical record also this years and last years. With 21 game in basketball, so no one they beat us in 21 game. And I think we can we win the possession ball in these 2 years only 12 times or 10 or 12 times, with more than. Then 18 plus 15 is more than 33 game, no? In more than 33 game, we win possession ball 12 times, 10 times. So it's not so important for me, but important for me attack. And for important for me attack altogether. Many coach, when I listen interview, they say, I like attacking football. I like to score. Then at the end, maybe they score like normal number. I really followed the other sport at all. So, I mean, rugby, I'll follow the basketball. I really don't care if we get goal. I really care if we score more goal. And this many time is a fighting between psychology, inside psychology of the player. No, many times they say, oh, we receive a goal. But if you watch some game, we receive 1-2 goal and then we score 3-4 goal. I mean, we all the time we like to attack. And for me also, one big decision for me, lose and draw is really so bad. Loss and draw is like a draw for me is loss. I mean, because we have 3 points, no? When you maybe before, no, football is was 2 points, okay. But when we have 3 points, three draw is mean one win, three. So for me, it's always attack for win. It's important, and doesn't matter we lost 10-0, we lost 1-0, we reached 0 points. And doesn't matter we draw 1-1 or 2-2, we reach only 1 point. It's been zero for me. And for me, it's important attack. And if I need to win, I don't know if you see some game, I put even my keeper in attack and I don't care. I put every player in attack because we need to win. We need to in and have all the time balance in the team. I think we done a so good job. I think we change a bit mentality of Indian football, at least my team. We offer different mentality because in India, almost all team, I-League and ISL, they defend with 4-4-2. They play with 4-2-3-1 that now in Indian football, they're going so well. In India, it's different that you play with three central back. In many games, we play also with three defending central back. We really performance good and we offered some different kind of football for sure. And I'm so proud about my player that no one have a big experience. So I select a player almost that they don't have so much experience because I believe in the job. I believe in my player always and in selection of the player always.
Coming to a bit onto the tactical part as well. So majority of the teams in I-League were defending in a low block against you, as you have mentioned, a 4-4-2 formation. In your previous podcast and even today, you said that my philosophy all the time is to attack. So while attempting to break the opposition's low blocks, were you attacking and target specific zones in the final third? Or did your strategies vary depending on the opposition style of play?
Well, Ingena is an opponent team that was adapted on us. I select all the time in my team speedy player. I select player that can create one versus one all the time. in the squad. I select Fletcher, that is Jamaica national team player, that was great, left foot, was great, one versus one, always. Luca, that is good finishing and speedy player, Fletcher, speedy player. GT and Emil Benny, that was two striker I put to play in the middle because I believe all the time in quality in the middle. Sharif Mohammed, that is a national team player of Afghanistan, all the time quality in the team. And I push with the left back, right back always. So I create this additional number in opposite team where we change position between left wing back, central forward, and we create confusion to all the time to the opponent that they don't know which player they need to follow in attack. And this it's happened in many games. In many games we use the strategy of counter-attack. In many games we create additional number in one zone. In many games we create additional number in central zone with the two central midfielder. We study opponent team a lot, but be honestly with you, like I say before, I noted that all the team in India, they use the block 4-4-2. Behind, we have a three midfielder, because I was playing with 4-3-3, three midfielder all the time. I was create three versus two in the middle that can create more possession in the center. But possession for attack, no possession to keep the ball. So more possession in build-up, I call possession build-up, that is not the same of possession of keep the ball in horizontal phase. More possession in build-up and more creative space in attacking with the three striker, plus the two additional midfielder, plus the two left and right back. So we was create a number of attacking phase all the time. And for me, everybody must defend, everybody must attack. Change positional each time during 90 minutes. The team that create a block for 90 minutes, one time for 45 minutes you can keep. But for 90 minutes, we will never keep. We score with in each team in the league last years and this years. We have medium on the score 2.7 in each game. I mean, I noted this in India. I talk about the team that we face, even also ATK, or I talk also about the Asian team. Also them, they was defend with 4-4-2 all the time. They was create all three team 4-2-3-1. Also ATK, Bayanga, Masia team, and Bajangara, the team of Bangladesh. All team, they have this defensive phase with 4-4-2. Was for me was easy in tactical phase to create additional number in attack, because when you defend deep, you can defend 4-5-1 or you can defend 4-4-2 in base of the quality of the two central back. I make this choice. And then you can attack with 7-9 player, depend about have one central left back with left foot is great as very very good possession with Bauba. Bauba is ex national team of Cameroon and was great one plus for us because it was the first build up player from them start all action. With the keeper also, when come Rashid, really create us starting all the time build up from the back. It was only one, two, three team that start build up from the back. All other team they try to play forward fast. We try to involve all play and build up to create the opponent team to come in our defensive phase and try to play forward fast with 2-3 pass, and we all the time we score, we create a lot of chance.
in India, Kerala and West Bengal are the two most football crazy states, along with the Northeast. A lot of people are crazy about football. So managing a team from Kerala, there is a lot of expectations from Gokulam Kerala. So how did you able to manage the expectations, keeping in mind most of the players when coming into the team didn't have any experience of playing at a very high level? So how did you manage the expectations?
Well, expectation is expectation first. They must have a expectation for me, because now you see me quiet, and but you need to be strong with them. And I was expect from them. I say from the first day, I come here for win. I don't come in here just for holiday or just for being normal coach. I don't want, in the first meeting, I say to them, I don't want to only win. I want to win and be happy after win. I want to sell all player better marketing. That can be an ISL or better quality or national team. This was my dream. And it's become like this with the time. You know, last years we changed most of all 8 players go to play in ISL. This years, I believe also after finish the league, many players will go to ISL. And Alex Saggi is reach a national team of under-23. That is very historical. No one player before was reach national team from Gokulam. And follow myself, because I create also family. No, I come from South Italy. I create family inside the group. Follow myself. No, many time I put out the phone before the training session, put out the phone before each game, because I don't want the distraction. I want they really believe in followers or in other stuff that they can influence unconsciously your mind. Even you don't want, they can influence yourself always. And be youth team, because we was very young. All team was young in experience. Is because they believe a lot in our job. We believe a lot in ourselves. Before each training, before each game, we believe in ourselves. We know that we was study each training for win. We know that we was study each training for reach 1 point, for reach the title. We don't care what the pressure of the media they will say from Kerala or from, like you say, Momadan. It was a big pressure also to all media, also to Football Federation. We really don't care. We only think about to win the title. And many times when they was asked me, the media marketing guys from our team, hey, let's public this from one player. Let's public this from another player. The best scoring, the best defender, the best. I would say, no, don't public nothing. I don't care about this, because I don't want the mindset of the player that was changed. Almost we have some statistically. It was with Luca, it was start to score a lot, was the top of the scorer, then he get the injury, but it was the top of scorer. Then he was asking me, okay, let's public look at the best scorer. I would say, no, nothing. Or they would say the best defender, no, nothing, because I want focus all the time in win. And in the next game, many times, not only in India, also in Italy, in all country, when you win, you relax. When you succeed something, you stop to believe in this and you relax, because maybe you think some agent contact you, you say, hey, next year you are in Excel, so you need to perform as well. So the mindset of the player all the time change. I want each player who's put the quality of individual quality for the team, not each player the quality for himself. Many of player in many teams have a big quality, more than Gokulam, for sure. But they put quality of themselves. They never put quality of what you want to believe. If you want to believe in something like reach the winner of I-League, you need to put quality of yourself to the service of the team, always. In this case, this creates many focus on themselves. No, in the team, they know during the game, they know what to do. and they don't care at all about pression outside. They are in pressure when they listen to me in the field. So
that's a nice way to manage the pressure. So now coming to another part of the managing a team, that is, you have said once again in the show that winning is the most important thing and losing and drawing is basically the same thing. So in last two seasons, your squad was mostly comprised of inexperienced Indian players and experienced foreigners. So how did you bridge the gap between these groups and instill your winning mentality?
Well, create a strong personality in each player. No? The youth guys, inexperienced guys, like you call them, all the time, the performance, we know that can be high and that can be down. In each game, they can do one amazing thing and they can do one bad thing during the game. Experienced players, they are standard. All the time in the performance, they are standard. Create together one feeling that is collage to be at a high level. I just manage to speak individually in a good way. Example, to some player, I need to speak strong. So I need to be angry on them and speak individually with them. To some player, I need to be strong in front of everybody, that everybody listen what I say. To another player, I manage to be quiet with them, because if you speak strong, maybe the personality is slow and they can do collapse and don't performance anymore. So I manage to communication. The communication is the basic of everything. I believe a lot in this, and I tell also another stuff that I believe in myself so much, and I think is this the best way. I treat foreigner people and local people at the same view. I don't make difference between one foreigner and one Indian, because woman there are India, woman I am, woman is another foreigner. So it doesn't matter for me that one foreigner have a big experience. Doesn't matter one foreigner come from national team. Doesn't matter he get more money than another local player. The same treatment they receive one foreigner for big budget, and the same treatment reach one local player with low budget. And attract the same person, the same view. For me, when we won all together. Also the massage, the kit manager or the team manager of the physiotherapy win. If we lost together. So I love to treat everybody, and each person is so important in the group. Each person. So, like I said before, each person must make 100% to the team. And I need to do 100% for them to make them happy. I need to valorization of each person. Many times in the meeting, I say thank you to the massage, or say thank you to the physio. I say thank you for the hard job that I was doing during this period. This make them something plus for them. It's not only we coaching only for money, or we receive money, then we coach better. No, we need to have some gratification. Some gratification is only one word. No, sometimes one word can make you happy more than money. And I believe a lot in this.
One thing you have said about coaching young players is that the more you give to them, the more they will give back to you. So what are the things that a coach should keep in mind while training the young players who are just right now in the scene?
For some of player, I was like a father, because we was in my bubble, because I was near to them, near to the room. I go to speak before each night. And for sure, when you have this league, very compact league, because we was playing each 3-4 days, you need to be near them in each kind of you can. Example, I really want that the guys believe in alimentation. I really want that the guys believe in resting. rest, take a good rest. I really want that the guys believe also in spiritual mentality before each game, you know? And this is really great one plus for us. And all the time, I give respect to the player, they give respect to me. We fight almost each day. Each day was one amazing fight in the training, in the breakfast, in the lunch, because we have a family. The best family, if you watch some good family, you see only that the best family, they fight. Who don't fight is mean you don't love each other. If you fight, you mean you love each other. And this I see in many meetings, no? Many meetings, I will say, if we don't fight, it means we don't love each other. We was loved too much and we fight too much. This is was something that really we was like a family. It's not only a word. It's really, it was like this. People, if we lost or we draw, when we draw one game, it was kind of no one speak. I mean, it was like in the bus. Some players cry, many players cry. In the first half, if he was losing 1-0, and then we win later, it was like a tragedy because we believe so much in the win and we are capable all the time to do it. And I think the relationship that we create between all group, everybody stimulate each other for win. And we start from zero to create this this feeling, training by training, to create the winning mentality, training by training. Many times in the training, you know, we stopped the training because it was tragedy, fight, too much tackle, because we it was like in each training was one performance like a game.
You said that treating everyone right. So especially for the young players, when you treat everyone who is just like, you know, be the support staff, be it someone who cleans your room, be it someone who helps the team pack the boots, everything. It also creates the right environment for the younger players to how they should go in life. Because being humble something is very important in football, especially in young age, because sometimes you lose direction. So it's a very nice step to just do this thing. So one thing, another important thing is that sometimes after you win, you are a young player, you have won the championship, there is a lot of frenzy around you, you get a lot of attention, and Gokulam was the first time they became the champion. So sometimes after being the champion, the motivation levels drop certain times and the team becomes a bit more complacent. But Gokulam didn't. They just go on to win the league another time. So what were some of the things that you instilled when the season end and the new season begin, what you conveyed to the dressing room that helped the team just get the motivation right and didn't let the motivation level drop? Because sometimes winning becomes a habit, but sometimes winning can create complacency.
When some player was flying so high, I put them down. Easy. I have a strong personality to do this. And also the president give me free hand to select and to make decision, strong decision for each player. If some player want to fly so much high because they think he's, I change him, easy. Many player I changed in last years, I changed many player and they know, and they know, I can say they scared. They respect this decision because I'm straight. I'm straight with everybody. Strict, like also with the staff. Many time also the staff, if there are human beings, also we have a young staff this year. Many time the staff was maybe over think that, okay, they can do whatever they want. No, we are professional. We do, like I say, we do one job that is only 1 or 2 hours in the day. Other people, they kill themselves for half of their money for 12 hours of job, 8 hours of job. So they know the importance of I give them and they know the importance and the chance they can create something historical, because nobody win the league two time consecutive. Nobody for 21 game don't lost one game. Nobody believe in this. So I want and we make something that can be eligible and remind for all the time. Next year, 2 years, 3 years. I don't believe nobody can broken our record. It will be very difficult. And I hope, like I said before, I believe so much that my player, they become more men and more mature after this experience. I believe so much because I saw the behavior of the person when was coming in the first day in the training, and when now he's finished the session, he's become very so much mature, like a man, like personality, and is ready to have a really nice life, football life. Because many players, it was like academy player. Sauro come from the college. Emil Benny, Zeman, G-Team, Jasim, Alex, all coming from academy, from second reserve team. No one have a background. So everybody, nobody was experienced in my league. They kept experience only together.
You have guided them pretty well, and each of them turned not only tactically on the pitch, on the off the pitch, they have been very responsible. And most of our guests who have come here, they said that Gokulam Kerala was one of the best teams they have seen in I-League's history, because Gokulam was one of the teams who was very fiery and a very unique brand of football, which is not very, it's a not a very common thing in Indian football. So yeah, Gokulam was, and the youth players had a very important role to play there. Now coming to another part, that is former Spain head coach Vincente del Bosque once said, one healthy dressing room is worth more than 100 tactical hours. So what were the do's and don'ts of Gokulam Kerala's dressing room under your management? And how did you help maintain the mutual respect in between the players and also your support staff?
Well, sure. Respect, responsibility for each job. Because each person in the team have one rule. Put the quality, like I say, in service of the team, not the quality for themselves. Believe in only teamwork. Believe in only one focus. The focus is the 3 point. Doesn't matter how you reach this 3 point. Important that at end of the game, you reach the 3 point. And the hard work all the time pay. Hard work all the time pay. I remember that many training sessions, we was play each 3-4 day. And many time, I don't know, Prof. Garcia, the prof say, "Oh, coach, it's too much. Maybe we need to relax them." No. For me, hard work pay always. And many times maybe they will say, "Oh, coach, we need to stop the train because they fight too much contact." I allow them to beat themselves in the game, in the training, because I believe in hard work. I believe in when you training hard. Many times I see other team, because we was nearby to the field, especially in South Lake, they train too soft. I believe in hard job. Hard job give all the time successful. Hard job pay all the time. And feedback of each player, when you have some good feedback from the player, or even negative feedback from the player, you can learn something from them and you can adapt yourself for them. Make some individual training from some player. It's the key of successful also. We do a lot individual training for some player that maybe they cannot jump by mentor, some player that are no good man-to-man to marking, or some player that are no good to make a diagonal side, or some player that are no so well attentive in attacking phase, when they must cut or when they must reach the ball nearby or when they must attack in the profundity. So we try to improve themselves individual, and I think we really deserve to be like leadership in each training and also in each game.
One advice that you would like to give to all the aspiring coaches around the globe?
Well, one good advice for the coach is be different. Because if you are the old coach, I saw a lot of coaches, they start to copy each other. Too many coaches, they copy each other. Example in I-League, for me, it's a bit sad also that each team was played with 4-2-3-1. Some team was playing 4-3-3, okay, but I don't see rotation of the player. I see all the time maybe they play the same player. I saw that they play in the same attacking phase, and I think we need to improve. You need to be different. If you want to achieve something, you need to be different. You need to put focus on the hard job. You need to listen everybody, all stuff that you have, but you need to make only one decision. If I can say, you need to attack, because more goal, they create more enthusiasm to not only to the team or not only to the supporter, but to individual player. No, if one player score, they will give more goal the next game. If one player make a goal, share him goal with himself, with him girlfriend, with him wife, they make himself more confident, and next game they will pay you more and more. Give the confidence to the player to do the maximum that they can. Not only training the team, but training the player individually for reach the best for the team.
So, captains, that was all for today. We need to end our session here. Thanks, Mr. Vincenzo Alberto Annese, for being with us today. To all of our viewers, thanks a lot for tuning in. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more such podcasts like this. So, until next time, it's goodbye. From Ambed.